Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the maker of heaven and earth, the Word made flesh, the Lord and giver of life. Amen. Let us come into the light of Christ, confessing our need for God's mercy. God of peace, we confess that we are not at peace with others or with ourselves. We bring to you all that tears us apart: discord in our families, violence in our world, our own conflicted hearts. In your mercy, mend us. Reconnect us to one another and to you. Let peace reign over all the earth. Through the Prince of Peace, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. In the Word who has come to dwell with us, God has given us grace upon grace, forgiveness that is stronger than our sins, love that can heal every broken heart. Hear this word of God's pardon and peace. In the name of Jesus, our Savior, you are free from all your sins. Rise, shine, for your light has come. Amen. From God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace and peace be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, you wonderfully created the dignity of human nature, and yet more wonderfully restored it. In your mercy, let us share the divine life of the one who came to share our humanity, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My soul shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself like a priest with a beautiful headdress, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels, so as the earth brings forth its sprouts, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to sprout up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to sprout up before all the nations. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet, until her righteousness goes forth as brightness, and her salvation as a burning torch. The nations shall see your righteousness, and all the kings your glory, and you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. Word of God, word of life. The Holy Gospel according to Luke. And when the time came for their purification, according to the law of Moses, they brought Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every male who first opens the womb shall be called holy to the Lord. And to offer a sacrifice, according to what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves, or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And this man was righteous and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. And he came in the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him according to the custom of the law, he took him up in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, that you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel. And his father and his mother marveled at what was said about him. And Simeon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, Behold, this child is appointed for the fall and rising of many in Israel, and for a sign that is opposed. And a sword will pierce through your own soul also, so that thoughts from many hearts may be revealed. And there was a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived with her husband 7 years from when she was a virgin, and then as a widow until she was 84. She did not depart from the temple, worshiping with fasting and prayer night and day. And coming up at that very hour, she began to give thanks to God and to speak of him to all who were waiting for the redemption of Israel. And when they had performed everything according to the law of the Lord, they returned into Galilee to their own town of Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom. And the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord. What's in a name? Asked Shakespeare. Well, our names identify who we are. We choose names for our children in hopes that it will describe what they are or what they might become. We gave names to organizations and institutions to say what they will be. Names tell us something about what is happening. Christmas. Now there's a name. A name of a very special day in the history of the church, also in the history of the culture. But don't the two get mixed up? I'm reading more and more in the last couple of days how Christmas is over. Done. Finished. The lights are down. The sales over. The tree out by the curb to be picked up by the trash collectors. Christmas is over. And it's time for the after Christmas sales. Of course, we go through this rather silly, I think, argument in recent years around you mustn't say Christmas. You must say Happy Holidays, lest someone be offended. I read yesterday about a man who was boarding a plane in New York City. The flight attendant wished him a Merry Christmas, and he went berserk. The pilot came out to try and calm him down. Security came. The man was removed from the airplane, and everyone else on board cheered. What's in a name? The Christ Mass is just that. It is the central service of the church, celebrating the coming of God among us as one of us. It happens on a specific day in a specific form, and it has a very special message. God is among us as one of us, and that changes the world. That's the message of Christmas. All the other stuff is just extra. The gift giving, the decorating, the buying, the selling, the parties, they're nice. But they go away from what is central to the day and the season. So when someone tells you that Christmas is over, well, wish them a happy fourth day of Christmas. There are eight more yet to come. On our block, we're always the last ones up with our Christmas lights, and we're always the last ones down. And I think the neighbors think we're weird. But there is something special and specific about this day that can't be covered by whatever the mall says or the commercials on TV say. Now, some of us can remember the comic strip Little Abner. And in that comic strip, there was a character called the Shmoo. Who remembers the Shmoo? The Shmoo would be whatever you wanted the Shmoo to be. If you wanted a loaf of bread, the Shmoo was a loaf of bread. If you wanted a car, the Shmoo became a car. Whatever you wanted, the Shmoo would become. I think we're there. We've passed through the season of celebrating Christmas to the season of whatever. In a global community, how can any faith make unique claims? All paths lead to the same destination, don't they? Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Well, that's your opinion. And the holidays covers, well, whatever we want them to cover. They can begin at Labor Day and end whenever. And I'm amazed at how church people let the mall decide what the celebration of Christmas is all about. They're playing Christmas music at Boscov's. What's this Advent hymn stuff? Why do we have to wait when Santa Claus is at the mall in October? But we've passed through a time of waiting, through a time of preparation, through a time of anticipation to this announcement. God is among us as one of us. And that can change the world. We are people of a particular proclamation. We are called not to go with the flow, not to fit in, but perhaps to stick out a little bit, to be in the world, but not of the world. How many times have you heard in the last month or so, "Oh, how I wish Christmas could last all year"? How many times have you heard people say, "The true meaning of Christmas is..." and they never finish the sentence. The true meaning of Christmas becomes a shmoo. It becomes whatever we want it to be. But the true meaning of Christmas is that God has looked on His beloved creatures, seen how lost we are, how we cannot save ourselves, and has come to save us from our own brokenness. I was driving over to the mall the other night. Yes, I do my Christmas shopping in about 2 days. But I drove past Atonement Lutheran Church, and on their lawn, they have a new creche. It's very striking. Three large beams come together to form the stable. Inside are three very simple cutout figures of Joseph and Mary and the manger. But one of the beams, the one that stands over the manger, is a cross. It reminds us that the coming of Jesus into the world was to buy us back for God, and to do so through the cross. Jesus does not come to eliminate our pain, our suffering, and our brokenness, but to change it, to redeem it, to overcome it. The true meaning of Christmas is not living happily ever after, or always having each day be joyous and full of gifts and celebrations, but rather to celebrate the gift that we are given each day. The epistle reading appointed for today speaks to God's people from Paul's letter to the Colossians as to what it is to live Christmas every day. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish each other in all wisdom. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him. It's not through lights and trees, not through wrappings and parties and sumptuous feasts, but through simple acts of Christian love and charity towards one another. Through acting not as the world does, but as Christ does towards one another. That's how it becomes Christmas today and tomorrow and the day after that and after that and after that. Amen. Let us affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. In joy and wonder, we pray for the church, for those in need, and all of God's creation. O Son of God, come down. Be among us today and show us that your way is so much better than our own. Teach us to love, to forgive, to support and care for each other so that no one among us may say, I am alone, but I have been touched by God's love. Hear us, O God. Gracious God, in this season of giving and getting, remind us that the greatest gifts are those that do not come in packages or wrappings, but the gift that you give us of yourself in a manger in Bethlehem, in your word, in bread and wine, in our forgiving and loving of each other. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Lord God, we lift before you all those who are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other trouble. Hear especially the persons and concerns we name before you now, especially Barbara and Jean, and those we name before you aloud or in our hearts. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Walk with us and among us. Show us your way until we too hear your words, well done, thou good and faithful servant, and take our place at the feast which has no end. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Almighty God, we entrust to you all for whom we pray, confident that you fulfill your promises through Christ our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us pray. God of mercy and grace, good and loving God, we rejoice in the birth of Jesus, who came among the poor to bring the riches of your grace. As you have blessed us with these gifts, let them be blessing for others. With the trees of the field, with all earth and heaven, we shout for joy at the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy One, the beginning and the end, the giver of life, blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophets' hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your Son, Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his followers, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ died. Christ is risen, finished. We believe Christ will come down again. With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming. Come, Lord Jesus. Holy God, we long for your Spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awake your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth. Come, Lord Jesus. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The mystery hidden for ages is revealed to us in this meal. Come, behold, and receive your God. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. O God, whose grace and truth are revealed in the Word made flesh, bless those who go forth to share your word and sacrament with those who are sick or homebound or imprisoned. Nourish and strengthen those who receive this Holy Communion, that through the body and blood of your Son, all may rejoice at his birth and come in his presence among us, now and forever. Amen. May the word that Mary brought to birth carry you into a new and abundant life. Amen. May the word that Joseph cradled in his arms enfold you with love and strength. Amen. May the word that the angels proclaimed in song bring harmony to our world. Amen. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace. Christ is with you. Thanks be to God.